wild charades player, but charades in teams, and they were out for blood. If you didn't know what you were doing and you made stupid guesses or you couldn't act it out, Gene would really seriously get angry.
We were very competitive. There were quite a few competitive people, but maybe Gene and I were the most competitive.
After a blistering Saturday night of charades, the competition moved outdoors for one of Kelly's notorious Sunday volleyball games.
There was an A team, of course Gene was the head of that, and they played pretty competitively and seriously. They really played volleyball, and then there was a kind of secondary, messy team that just would jump up to have fun and was taking a very long time to finish the game, and Gene was upset.
The tension was such we began to laugh from nervousness and couldn't score a goal. We stayed on the court longer and longer, and finally he was infuriated. And he went into the house, and as he went in, he stamped his foot on the door sill going into the kitchen and broke his ankle. And so Fred Astaire did Easter Parade.
Kelly had been rehearsing Irving Berlin's Easter Parade for a month. 3 days after the accident, a recently retired Fred Astaire was back at work.
Anyway, it was Gene's idea. He called Fred Astaire and said, listen, you know, I've broken my ankle, we're supposed to start shooting. It was Astaire's comeback. It was actually great.
The press and public constantly tried to create a rivalry between them. But Astaire and Kelly enjoyed a mutual admiration, clearly seeing that their interests and strengths were miles apart. Among Hollywood's leading male stars, when it came to song and dance men, there were only two.
Fred represents the aristocracy when he dances, and I represent the proletariat.
Directed by Vincent Minnelli, the duo worked together for the first time in the 1946 review film, The Ziegfeld Follies. Kelly later said that he agreed to the number out of respect for Astaire, who had performed it on stage years before. Describing it as bland, Kelly typically wished for something more demanding for the pair.
Gene and Fred had very different styles, there's no doubt about it. Fred was used to ballroom dancing. Gene was far more athletic. Gene had a lower center of gravity. Gene danced closer to the ground.
Well, Gene always liked to dance low, and Fred always liked to dance high. It was a whole different concept of dancing.
His tapping is quite aggressive, you know, strong, loud, clear tapping, and he seems to be digging in there as opposed to Astaire, who sort of skims and floats.
Gene was very physical. In fact, my husband says that he could always tell who I'd been working with when I came home at night, because if I didn't have a mark, it was Fred Astaire. And if I was black and blue, it was Gene Kelly.
You give your heart to Fred Astaire, but you save your body for Gene Kelly.